So anyway, I wrote this sheet about, I don't know, a month ago or two, maybe more. But it was like, oh, it could be a business, I guess. And I'm like, I don't know, because it's like financial advice to give to people, and you give people financial advice, and then they go jump on the financial cliff, and something happens, and they blame you. But I'll give it out anyway. But yeah, it was kind of like, what it is like if you, it originally started out if you're a renter, and then you're gonna buy, but then you only have like savings, like from your IRA. And you're retired and you want it to last and last and last like your whole life through, or at least 20 years. Okay, so I made that for a house purchase based upon a retirement savings. And so yeah, unfortunately everything looks so good if you had like 200,000 or more. It just looks great. As soon as you start getting into numbers under 200,000, it's just like, oh crud. Yeah, just crud. You're just gonna be stuck with renting somehow, somewhere. If you have Social Security. So yeah, I don't know. But it in a way it could help people. I put like an area for siblings. If you have 10 brothers and sisters, it'll try to do the math on. 10 years from now, or 12 years from now, how much is there? If he buys a house, or if she buys a house. So yeah, it does give those kind of things. I also included like if you're gonna purchase land and build a house, that's an option always because it's like a cheaper loan. It's not a big deal. So yeah, you have that can go on. But oddly, those ones almost evened out financially wise, buying the house outright or building, if it was a really, really cheap property, if it was just like a $100,000 house, they almost didn't matter. It was just the initial shock of the mortgage, going through that mortgage, that's the big deal, versus, when you buy the house is the bigger mortgage versus if you just get the land and you build on your own time frame. It's just not the big have to. So yeah, you have a smaller one. But so anyway, so yeah, so that's where I'm at with all of that. I think it's okay. It's nothing great, and it's one of those. It's like a PMI formulator that they give you. I think it's, I only set it up for monthly, so I may not give all the enhanced interest rate that's owed to the bank that I should, but it's still valuable. I still think it's a valuable tool to use. But yeah, I don't know. Don't distress if you have less than, I guess it'll give you an eyeball picture if you can actually buy off of your IRA. And yet I also included things like you have to, you can't just, take everything out of that because you have all these expenses in life expenses that happen, and that's what those things are really for, So you have to always have enough years in succession that will assist for all kinds of things, cars, whatever you have to buy. So yeah, so I included that, but I don't know. It's kind of okay. I there's a 20-year version I put out there, and then there's a 5-year version sheet. The 5-year version sheet was silly. That was just, buy the house and pay it off really, really, really fast. That was really why I did it. But that really, in many cases, just will drain IRAs to zilch, and that's not good. Along with these things are supposed to go to like 106. That's what they're quoting, 106 years old. And yeah, people do live that long. So it's good to think about, yeah, you can go ahead and buy a house if it's possible, go ahead and do it, but if it's not possible, don't. So that's really what this is all about. So anyway, so I'll give you the URL to it, and like anything, yeah, house prices here versus house prices there. Oh my gosh, the distance, but yeah, it's like, I don't know. So we're talking about the